website of DSNA. Let me step back to diaspora with a lawyer case. I am not sure how many of you here try to Google it. Google has become a generic term. Have you Googled any time Brahman, B-R-A-H-M-A-N? What did you get? What did you get? Did you get the BSNA? No, Brahman Bulls. I'm not kidding, try it. Brahman Bulls. What, if so, those of you who are not familiar with what I'm talking to you, they breed a special type of bull for winning competitions and all that, and they get points, and it's a special breed. That's a huge operation, Brahman Bulls Association. So how can you win that battle? I have one suggestion. Others may have better suggestions. For want of convenience, in order to succeed with Googling this thing, Brahman, instead of as expected in English language, just bite the bullet and lowercase b, capital case b into lowercase b. So Google will go and search, will not find a capital case b to match with the bull, but will come to our
but
bull.
This Brahman bull has come from India, by the way, from Indian origin.
I accept it, sir, no problem. But the point is that we are not conveying what BSNA stands for.
I'm just kidding. I'm just wanted you guys to know.
I appreciate that. And that
I've done some study on that.
Mishra ji is right, because see, we call the, if you know Mahabharata, the part was on the Vrishabha. The Vrishabha is about the bull.
I have no problems with the interpretation. All that is that if BSNA has to convey its message, how are you going to reach the target population?
Pandeji, I do want to make a comment, because I also went through the same process, Brahman as Google. In fact, cattle were domesticated by two people in the history of mankind. And one were Brahmins. And that is why actually they have named it as Brahman.
I have but no problems with interpretation. I have never disagreed with either of you. All that I'm saying is that if BSNA has to reach a target population, we need to focus the thing in a proper way. How to get around the problem? If you keep a capital B, Google is going to kill you.
Yeah, that's right.
If you lowercase it, what the logic of Google is that it is going to look for similar sounding words and take you where you want to go. If some of you have been following this Google business, this Sergey Brin and the other fellow, I forget his name, they were both graduate students in Stanford about 17 or 18 years ago. All that is, they were master students, and they developed the algorithm how to log on to similar sounding things and patented it. That's it. That's all. All that they did was they wrote the algorithm how to link two sounding things together. And that's it, that's master's thesis, and they are multi-billionaires. That's besides the point. My point is very simple, that in order to pass the BSNA word in a multilingual forum, we need to target what it is and render the materials into a medium that which they can understand. And you can use Baraha software or Lakini software. These softwares will convert linguistically and etymologically into equivalent languages, whether you are in Assamese or whether you are in Bengali or Gujarati, whatever you want to do. Yeah, let's go to the next, please. Whenever we have the BSNA conventions, this is too early and we are struggling to build a way of approaching the problem, we should try to get one or two speakers in that language to come and talk and approach the people. And then after this conference is over, hopefully some of these materials will come on the web page. I urge all of you that are here to speak to your Assamese, Gujarati, Telugu, Tamil, all the friends that you think are receptive to these ideas. Therefore, pass the word on. What else you need? We have all aged gracefully. As we age gracefully, we have also reached a point in our lives, we are looking for what next step. An example will be, some people come and you know, they pass away and they're desperately looking for help for their last rites. Who's going to render it? Who's going to render it? Ultimately, they're looking for Brahma. And the temples have been sources of these materials, and usually, sometimes, but not always, the temple priests will help. But some temple priests I know firsthand refuse to do these things. They will only for good functions. So, as we age, we need the services, and somewhere along the line, I can't ask BSNA to do all these things, but it happens to be the Brahmanical right to do these jobs. Thus, we need to have a link in the same way. Earlier this morning, there was another point made that how are we going to teach our children all these things going on? We had a mini session of BSNA in Edison, New Jersey in the month of December. Every Hindu temple I know, to the best of my knowledge, unless they are more recent ones, have always a Bal Vihar. And every Bal Vihar has, starting from grade A to whatever, grade Z, depending on what it is, they have students and they have curriculum. Mr. Bhatt, I forget his first name, Omji, he gave the presentation in Edison on how Chetan Bhatt gave the presentation of how the Bal Vihar was being done, is being done at Bridgewater Temple in New Jersey. Bridgewater Temple in New Jersey, take my word, unless you have seen the place, it's at the cutting edge of Hinduism, and it's a Venkateshwara temple, and some of you may know or may not know, it's in New Jersey. Needless for me to say, my last memory tells me about 38% sticks in my head, but more than 30% of area in and around Edison and Westminster and Princeton are all South Asians. There are so many Hindus, you just don't have a problem going there trying to find what it is. When she spoke this morning of our experiences in the US in 1965 and 67, there was not an Indian. If we saw somebody with the speaking Indian language, we ran after them and talked to them, right? And then she came in and joined me when I was in graduate school. That worked out good. But since we had an apartment, a pot of rice and sambar doesn't cost anything. We used to have all Indian friends around. Saturday, Sunday, no questions. They came for food. We had no problems. That was enjoyable. And they are, I want to tell you something else. Those friends that we made in 1965, 67, are still friends of ours. Others have come and gone. Come and gone in our intellectual spectrum. But more on a physical contact basis, they continue to be friends no matter what. They always are very grateful for that sambar and rice. And the Chinese have it right. In order to catch a man, the best way is through his stomach. How do they do it? They cook a big pot of rice. You go to a Chinese restaurant, you get a big pot of rice. So enjoy the joke. But seriously, in order for this morning, the points were made that how are we going to educate our next generation? The Bal Viharas have a wonderful program, and I am hoping that BSNA will have a link and people will be able to download and pass the word around to the community at large that BSNA is not a danger organization. It is a source of information for you for ongoing benefits. Let's go next slide. At this point, you heard part of it. We have been here for a while. That tells us we went to the Ganesh temple in 1970s for the first time. And then that temple, by the way, those of you who don't know, is the first Hindu temple that was consecrated, if my memory is right, about 1972 or 73. Then came the Pittsburgh temple. There used to be a UN official, Mr. Alagappan, who was an undersecretary of the UN, who took up on himself to make sure that the Hindu temple was built, and it was built smack in the middle of redneck area in Queens. In the beginning, they used to throw fishes and meat in front of the doorway and all that. Now you go there, you cannot believe how big it is. And the neighborhood around it has so blossomed to India world. And here comes a traveler from New Delhi and says, I want you to take me to Jai Kishan Bazaar. Please take me to Jai Kishan Bazaar. Translate that. from Jay Kishan Bazaar to Jackson Heights. This says something about us and why we are here and what we are doing. We have been here from 1965, and then our children are grown. They are all here locally, and so on and so on. Go to the next slide. Point to the next slide, please. What concerns all? There is no single question. There are many questions, many answers. There are many temples, mandirs, centers in most of India. Most of them have pujaris, Hindu pandits coming from India. What are our concerns? Go to the next slide. The largest diaspora are the Indians that we know. Go to the next slide. Different languages. I want you to, this is a rather crowded slide, but I will comment on it in an open fashion so it's much easier. Look at what happened in the Caribbean. Those of you that are familiar with the history there, the British signed up Indians to come to work on the sugar cane plantations. How did they do that? They figured out, let's take 10 Brahmins, 20 Kshatriyas, 30 Vaishyas, just for my convenience of discussion, 60 Shudras to do it. So for all these people, the downcast and Dalits, for all these people to render the service of religion requires, 10 Brahmins are enough, right? After 30, 40 years, they worked as indentured laborers. What happened to them? They couldn't pay back the loans to the British, so they couldn't go back. They got stuck. So what happened to them? They stuck there. And then what happened when they had to marry the oldest child? The first child of a Brahmin family was allowed to marry a Brahmin child because there was nobody else around. The rest of them watered down. Where are we now here in US? That's what I want you to carry home. She talked this morning about President Lyndon Johnson and immigration policies. The immigration policies in these countries have improved a lot. We are lots of us, there are many of us, there are wild amounts of variation, whatever. Therefore, the model that applied so far in the Caribbean, the same model existed in South Africa, does not apply here. We are more open, more available, and more educated. Thus, it is not a limited group of people we are working with. The process of acculturation you borrow from other cultures. I guarantee, in this group of audience, people in my age group, or at least those that have grown children, have blended families. I hope you understand what I'm saying. They marry mainstream children. Those children I have seen, they are married, and also some of them are so religious and they study about our language and culture and learn. So this slide only tells you that this is a process of acculturation, that we are prone to the forces of culture, other cultures on our culture, but given the immigration pattern, we do not exactly fall into the model that existed in the Caribbean or in South Africa. But ours is much more open and much more available. But also we are highly more educated than most other people. And also the process of blending taking place. So we are all aware of it. So what do you do here? You get a daughter-in-law who is a mainstream person. She needs to know a little bit about Hinduism. We need to make available whatever it is that needs to be done. So that process tells you the acculturation process. Next. Children, when they are ready to make whatever decisions, they do it on their own, but we need to set up some mechanisms should they want to contact, and I think Mrs. Avasthi is the contact person in BSNA. There's an email address, and I don't know whether it will benefit you or it will not benefit you, but it will not hurt to pass the word around saying, hey, here it is, see what you can do. If you want to follow, that's fine. If you don't want to follow, we just have to accept the reality. And you know, my daughter comes and says, I'm going to marry this person, I love him. So you shrug your shoulders and Lord bless you and move forward. Next. This is an ongoing process. I forgot to add, there's the Caribbean, and Fiji is another one. You understand, Fiji is also the same thing. But the beauty with Fiji is that the Hindus have established a number of ashrams, especially Ramakrishna Mission and Chinmayananda Mission. They are really, really active, and the Hindu community survives very well. If some of you follow the politics of Fiji, I don't, but I follow it occasionally. Not too long ago, in the last two or three elections, the chief minister had been an Indian origin person. So we are doing okay. We could be doing better, but we have to protect our behind without sacrificing anything. So we can learn from history, and I already commented on all these points. So you know the courses are taking place. We are in USA in a similar situation, but not as bad as what has happened at next slide.
Natarajan, one example.
Yeah.
Dr. C. Chenna, who is sitting, is from British Guyana.
Yeah.
He will tell you how the system.
You know, I welcome you to add your comments, and I. Permit me to end my conversation and discussions with you. I will talk to you individually. If you have any collective questions, we will be happy to respond to you. And Omji, sorry, Omji, I put in your lap a lot of response with you.
Yes, no, thank you. Thank you. Just to wait.